Hi, class. I'm teacher Ting Ting. Today is our second Chinese lesson. I will teach you how to write Chinese characters. So, please focus and pay attention. And also, what would you like to learn in lesson 3? Let me know after class. Okay? Great. And today, I brought my tiny blackboard. So I can write some Chinese characters. And also explain how to write it. It sounds great. So, let's start with the first character. You guys know Chinese uses different strokes to make characters. So, to learn how to write Chinese, you have to first know each stroke. So, let me show you each stroke and tell you how to write it. Okay. Here is a our first one. So, can you guys tell me how many different strokes there in this word? A little bit difficult. It's okay. Let me show you. So here you see a simple bat. We call it a dian. Dian. Yeah. And it's this way. This part, you write it left to right. We call it a heng. Heng. Yeah, great. So you can see here, it's very straight. We call it a shoe. Can you see it? Okay, great. Shoe. And this part, this joke, call it go. Go. You write it that way. And also here is a heng. It's a similar this part. And here is a new one. You write it this way. We call it pie. And Pierre have a very good brother. Is here. We call it Na. Yeah, his brother. Okay. So we know Pierre is this way, and his brother is that way, but it looks very similar. So that's it about this word. Right now, let's see another character. Okay, let me write another word. So, here is our second word. You can see here have our Pierre, and this part is we just learned called a shoe. And this part have two similar, but this one is a little bit shorter, that one is a little bit longer, but they all called Heng. So you just need to remember, you always write the top. So the top, we are always a little bit shorter, and the bottom, we are always a little bit longer. That's the Chinese thinking about the balance. So it's really easy rules. Okay. Next part, we going to learn about the strokes order. Before you start writing Chinese, you have to remember the stroke order. Actually, we have a very simple rules. You need always remember top before bottom, left before right, and the center before wings. Let me give you example. So, let's write this very simple Chinese word. I think maybe you know what it means. This is a number three, we call it san, yeah. And you can see this word have a similar stroke, and just like I told you, The top one, will it be shorter? The bottom, will it be longer? If you have another one in the mid, should be ready to more short. Okay, so when you read this word, you need to read this part first. Okay. So let's see the what I'm talking about. Top, before, bottom. Mm-hmm. So here is top, and we write it this way. Mm-hmm. So this is the right order. Mm-hmm. And the next example, told you left before right, here is another number, tell me if you understand. That's either what we just learned, brother, Pierre, and na. Is that right? Okay, you remember? So when you write some characters like this, you always write left first and right. Mm-hmm. Can you remember it? Okay, good. And I said center before wings. You may be a little bit confused. What does it mean, wings? Let me show you this word. You maybe can understand. Okay? So this part and this part is what I talk about, wings. Mm-hmm. And here is the center. So when you write some words like this style, you always write center first and wings. Okay? This is really easy. Okay, let me clean it. So today we learn different strokes and also know which part you need to write first. Mm-hmm. We learn about the order. I think right now you know how to write some simple Chinese word. Mm-hmm. Okay, so today I will also teach you another situation about Chinese. Mm-hmm. Actually, most Chinese words mix two of more characters together to make a word. So, let me give you this word. I really like it, and also it's a very good exam. they say the word we call the 女. That is mean girl. And this word, this one, we call the 子. This means man or boy. But they can mix together, be another word that says how. Because you guys always say ni hao. That says this word. So, actually, Chinese is very interesting. And have a lot of rules. If you can remember it, that will be really easy to learn it. Because you can think about why it called ha. If a girl with a boy together, that is a very good thing. Is that right? Or you can think about if a girl pregnant have a son, have a children, that is also mean good. So if you think about that, you can remember this word very, very quickly. And also, I have another one. It's also very interesting. Let's see this one. This one is not mixed two together, mixed three same characters together and to be another word. It looks very cute actually. So, who can tell me what it means? Let's guess it. Did you remember I told you this word means mouse? We call it cow. What does that mean if we have three mouths? This word means taste. You use mouth to taste something. Why have three? That's it because you know Chinese people, we really like drink tea. And we have one rule about tea. You have one little cup tea, but you only drink it three times. That is this word comes from. It's talking about tea. Normally, I'm talking about wine, you know, You need to enjoy something, taste something. It's a very interesting one. I want to share it with you today. And another one is also have this part. Actually, we have a lot of Chinese word have this part, but this time the right part is different. Maybe this part a little bit difficult, but it's okay. Let me explain to you. This word is also mixed two different characters together. This is my Chinese name. It's called Ting. Yeah. This part is mean girl, so you can understand this word is only for girl. You're not going to see some boys use this word. And the red part is called Ting. When you mix them together, that it mean pretty girl. Yeah, it's a very normally Chinese name actually. Okay. And also when you read this word, you read the left part first and the two red part, and we read the top before button, left before right. Still remember? Okay, great. Great. Let's see another word. This not the right character, left and right. This is one makes two different characters, but read it top and the button. This word mean man. Also, it's very easy to remember it because the top part is mean farm, and the button is mean power. So some human people have a power and work in farmer. What's that? It's me, man. Yeah, man. Nan. We call it Nan. Long, long times ago, only men were working farmer in farm. And the girl maybe staying home. Their job is maybe make a swing or make a food. Today I want to show you a lot of very interesting characters. Here is another one. Seems like a I just told you the taste, that one. Here's a word. We call it wood. Mean wood. Moo. Yeah. Moo. What's his mean? You have a three. I think this is our most interesting word today, maybe, because it's very interesting. This part is one word, three together is one word, and two together is also another word. But you don't need to feel confused because they all talking about same meaning. One is mean wood. Two together, two is mean trees. Tree, yeah. And the three together, that is a lot of trees. So three together is mean forest. So it's very, very easy to understand. Is that true? I think who invented this word is very smart. Okay. Like the my black belt, it made of wood. Okay. And let's see our last one, okay. Okay. Good. Last one is this is one word, and here's another one. You can mix them together, be another word. It's called zhang. Called zhang. You can use this word be your last name. Okay. So that is I want to teach you today. So next time maybe you guys can write some Chinese characters. Trust you can do it because it's not that difficult. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so that's the end of class for today, and forget tell me what you want to learn in Chinese lesson 3. Okay, I will be back. Okay. So, class, have a good day. I see you next time. Thank you to my lovely patrons, Huerna and Aris, for their support. If you would like to become a patron, check out my Patreon page for cool rewards.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe. And here are some other videos you might like to also check out my other ASMR channel, Sweet Dreams.